What's up, YouTube? Today we are going to be finishing up some rugs. Right here we have a full canvas taken off of the frame. What we're going to do is we're going to cut these out. We're going to do the backings. We're going to do some trimming, some carving, some shearing, and that'll be it. These rugs will be finished. So what we have here up top is a 2-foot by 4-foot custom commission logo rug. Then we have Tim's first ever tufted rug that he did entirely by himself. And then here I have a frame filler, so basically just not wasting the extra canvas that was available, I added a quick little lava lamp. So what we'll do is we're gonna use my electric scissors, we're gonna cut them out, we're gonna do some slits in the edges to do the waterfall edging, we're gonna add some premium felt backing, and then possibly some D-ring hooks. I think this one calls for D-ring hooks. I think he wanted it mountable. And then after the hooks, we're gonna flip it over and we're gonna do some shearing and some trimming on the edges. So stay tuned for the finished pieces. All right, so now that we have the rugs removed from the canvas themselves, what we're gonna do is we're gonna take a pair of scissors. I find that the electric scissors don't do very well on this part, so just some regular handheld scissors. And we're gonna make slits all the way around the edges so that we can hit the waterfall edging with some hot glue. And then that'll allow the edge to be like very clean and cleanly and uniform so that there is no leftover canvas like sticking out on the outside. So let's get to it. Okay, so now that we got all of the slits around every edge of every rug, and our hot glue gun is preheated, and we have our hot glue sticks right to the side of us because we're gonna need tons of them. What we're gonna do is we're just gonna apply hot glue to each individual piece and fold. Now when you fold, you're obviously going to want to pull that canvas over as far as it can go, so that what you're left with is a very clean and flush finish, which I will bring the camera up close so you guys can see front and center. Let me get this one down and I'll grab the camera. This part is super satisfying, especially if you didn't apply glue that goes excess like out of the rug, because that finish line is gonna be so clean. So let me show you.
So basically what I'm doing right here is just taking that adhesive, that hot glue, taking the canvas and folding it over, trying to make sure it's as flush and uniform as the piece before it, so that you have a really clean waterfall edge. And you're gonna wanna apply some pressure down so that one, obviously the hot glue is sticking, and two, so that it's not like raised or bumpy. And it should like look like that. So let's do the whole piece. Okay, so last but not least is we have the corner piece. What I like to do is when I am making my initial snips on all corners, I'll take off this entire triangular edge so that it does lay completely flush. And I'll show you what I mean. Let me get these last two glued and folded just like that. We're pulling the canvas away from the tufted part, getting that nice clean finish. And then for the edge, same thing, following in uniform all the way down. So we have this nice flush corner, just like that. I think that that is the most beautiful way to do edges. What do you guys think? Drop in the comments. Here's a little close up so you guys can see it is completely flush all the way to the corner, as well as that corner, as well as all of the others. So this one is done with the waterfall edging, and we're gonna move on to the next ones before we do and apply the felt backing.
Okay, so what I'm doing now is I'm going to clean off the tops very lightly with a handheld vacuum. And these aren't glued down at all. All I've did is the waterfall edge. So I'm going to attach one corner with hot glue, and then I'm gonna use spray adhesive for the rest of it. Then I'm going to go back around the edges with the hot glue to make sure that the felt is entirely secure onto the backing of the piece. Okay, so now that we have the waterfall edges on every piece, what we're gonna do next is we're gonna lightly remove all of the like leftover strings and stuff with a hand vacuum, clean it up just very lightly. We're gonna attach one edge with hot glue, which I've got the gun heating up again right now. Bam. And then after we attach one edge, we're gonna go back on this side with some spray adhesive, make sure it's all secure, and then go once around the edges with the hot glue gun again to make sure that the back is completely secure onto the actual piece itself. Let's get into it. So now that we got them all lightly cleaned up, what we're gonna do is attach one edge with hot glue. And I like to be really close to the actual edge itself. That way there is no ability to see the canvas from that side. Downward pressure, making sure it's nice and secured. For pieces like this size, I probably won't even use a spray adhesive. I might just trail it with hot glue because I have quite a lot. So we're gonna go ahead and do that all the way around all the edges. All right, so what we're gonna do now that the rug is entirely glued on is we're gonna just go over this edge here and see if there's any areas where it's just a little bit too separate for my liking. And we're gonna hit it again with some hot glue until it is completely secured as close to the edge as can be. So like right here, for example, hit it with just a little bit of glue. Apply some downward pressure. And then it's as close to the edge as you can get now. So I'm just gonna go over all of these little tiny pockets. Same process all the way through. And if it's already all the way to the edge, you don't need to hit it with more hot glue. We're just looking for those little areas that aren't as close as we'd like. Okay, so now that I have this little corner that's pretty tight here, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put my finger directly underneath it so I can feel just how far back to cut. And then I'm just gonna cut basically on top of my finger. Perfect, so that's right in the edge there. And I'm gonna do the same to the other side. If you don't feel comfortable with doing it like this, you can always flip the piece over and cut from the other side. Basically what I'm doing is I'm just still going around the edges and finding those little spots that don't have just enough glue. And we're gonna fill those in like so. That all looks good. Check this corner out. You don't have to be pressing a lot of glue into there. I just lightly squeeze it one time and then kind of push it around. So it's not like overloading onto the yarn because you don't want that. And then once this is done, we're gonna use scissors and just trim off the edges and it will be completely backed. All right, this side looks pretty good. Bam, let's trim off the edges. Now I've seen a lot of people trim the backing off this way, but I prefer to trim it off this way so that you can essentially use your thumb and your pointer finger and your index, whatever these two fingers are, and kind of like separate the backing from the front. So you can get a really nice, clean cut. So let's go around the entire thing. Should be a nice, clean edge like that. Okay, so what we're gonna do now is we're going to hot glue our edge down, same thing as we did last time. This time we are going to be adding D-ring hooks. So I'm not going to hot glue the entire backing. I'm only going to apply this to about 25%. And then we're gonna use spray adhesive.
So we're gonna do this 25% of all of the edges, and then we're gonna get that spray adhesive out, tack it back, and then add the D-ring hooks. Then go around again with the hot glue gun on the edges so we're all crispy and clean. Same process as the rug we just finished. Applying downward pressure, especially on the edges where I added just a little bit extra. All right, so this side is totally secured and super clean. So now we're going to shake that adhesive and apply it. All right, now what we're gonna do is we're gonna attach the D-ring hooks so that the piece can hang on the wall. What I'm gonna use is a measuring tape, my scissors, and some hot glue, and we're just gonna evenly space them on the back of the rug and then attach them, so you'll see right now. All right, now that we've got the hooks into the back, what we're gonna do is we're gonna apply a little bit more of this hot glue to the remainder of the back of the rug, and then we are going to add these last little screws in and then trim up the edges. All right, so we're almost finished with adding all of the hot glue around the edges, making sure that the rug is completely secured to the backing. And then we're gonna trim that excess felt off of the edges. And then lastly, we're gonna put these little screws in the D-ring hooks, and then the backing will be complete, ready to hang, and we'll need to shear the top with our carpet planer and briefly go over the edges, making sure everything is crispy. All right, now we're going to add our screws to the back of the rug. I use my tool to find the little hole and spin these suckers in, basically. Super easy. These D-ring hooks have two screws per hook. They can carry up to, I believe it's like 50 pounds, but I always double or triple up my hooks depending on how big the rug is. Sometimes I will put four just to disperse the weight very evenly. Okay, next one. Lastly, we will trim the little edges off, the little remainder, and we'll have a nice flush edge and a nice clean backing. Only thing left will be finishing the front. Bam. All right, so now that we've got the backing on all of our rugs, next up is the patches. Those are iron-on, so let's get the iron plugged in. All right, so we've got our iron-on patches. This one's gonna go here. This one's gonna go right on that one. Our iron is heating up. It's already hot. So let's apply the patches. That looks pretty centered. And voila, I like to use the front tip of the iron just to go over the edges, make sure there's nothing that is sticking up. And on to the next one. All right, so for this big piece, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take the measuring tape, divide that length in half, find the center, exactly 48 inches. So we're gonna put the patch at the 2-foot mark, so it's pretty much centered. Just like that. It looks juicy. Iron is hot and ready to go. I usually do about like a minute on the patch of just straight downward force, and then I'll take the tip of the iron and go around the edge. Make sure that there's no area that's sticking up, and it will be secured. The last step after the patches is flipping them over and cleaning up the front. So the backing is completely done after you put the patch on, hooks are in place, felt's all secured and tight, and then your patches are applied. This is rug number 189. You can always use your finger to kind of pull towards the center of the patch and see if there are any lips or edges that are sticking up, but that one's ready to go. All right, so now you can see the backs of the rugs are all applied, all simple and crystal clean, very secured, very crispy edges. Now we're gonna finish up the front.
All right, so next up is the carpet planing. So I've got my shears here. I've got my vacuum shop vac thing secured, plugged in, and ready to rock. This thing is a juicy power tool. It's extremely powerful. You don't want to get too close to the edges or you run the risk of snipping off part of the edge. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna lightly go over the top, and then I will use my hand scissors right here after I go over the top to clean up the edges. But honestly, this rug is pretty clean on its as it sits right now. So we're just gonna level off the top and trim up the edges, and it'll be complete. Let's do it. Alright, so last but not least, we are going to trim up our edges. Most people will use these, like shears, clippers, to go over the edge. I honestly prefer hand trimming my edges. It does take a lot more work. It is a lot longer, but I feel like the process is a little bit more uniform for me. So let's get to it. What we're gonna do is we're gonna go over these finished pieces with the hand vacuum, make sure that there's no leftover lint on the front or back, and they are ready to ship out. This is a custom commission. This is Tim's first piece he's ever made, and then this one will probably be on the website in a couple of days. So if you're interested in this one, stay tuned, it will be available. But yeah, thank you guys for watching along and hanging. Let's get these cleaned up, and I'll show you guys some final pictures.
All right, so we've got our finished lava lamp, Tim's very first rug. How do you guys think that turned out for a first timer? I think that's pretty impressive. And then we have our last piece over here, which is a commission, custom piece, looking real crispy, really good line work, really nice edges, and it's a mountable piece. So this will be on display in their house. I think they'll like it. What do you guys think? Drop in the comments, drop a like if you guys enjoyed this video. Hope to see you on the next one.